The opposition held its biggest show of strength so far in Kolkata at the Maha Adhivation. Rahul Gandhi, Congress president, was conspicuous by his absence. Why did the Congress not attend this big show of strength by Mamata Banerjee? Is the Congress going to be a central pillar in this opposition alliance, or can the Congress at best hope to play pillion? We're live in Davos tonight. We're focusing on the World Economic Forum, but this is election season, and we will continue looking at the Indian political landscape very closely. So before we get you all the interviews, all the reactions from the World Economic Forum, we want to deal with the biggest story of the day. Finance Minister Jetley, HRD Minister Prakash Javadekar questioning Rahul Gandhi's absence in Kolkata, saying that this shows that the opposition parties don't really want to work closely with the Congress and at best want to have the Congress play a pillion and tangential role. Here's the top political story tonight.
Is she Oshbe? 48 hours after the mega show of opposition strength in Kolkata, BJP on Monday pulled out the big guns to target the Mahagathbandhan. Leading the charge was Finance Minister, who put out a scathing blog saying that the agenda for 2019 was Modi versus chaos. Jetley accused the opposition of spreading negative anti-Modi agenda and said that there were four claimants for the Prime Minister's post. The Finance Minister also lashed out at Rahul Gandhi and the Congress.
It is a rally of rank opportunist elements. Those who could not see from eye to eye today have come together.
Unka irada ek majboor sarkar hoti hai to uske policies bhi neetiya bhi karyakram bhi aur pratyaksh kaam bhi apne apne swarthon ke liye kiye ja sakte.
Remember, a day after the opposition rally in Kolkata, the Prime Minister himself had called it an alliance against the people of India.
साथियों, ये महागठबंधन सिर्फ मोदी के खिलाफ ही नहीं, ये देश की जनता के भी खिलाफ है. अभी तो ये पूरी तरह साथ आए भी नहीं, लेकिन हिंसेदारी पर कैसे मोलभाव चल रहे हैं, लेखा जोखा चल रहा है, लेन देन चल रही है.
हम अच्छे दिन ले आएगा.
But while 22 parties united with the common cause of ousting Narendra Modi in the upcoming elections, the question is, do they have a common vision or a roadmap? And more importantly, who will be the Prime Minister face of this alliance? Karnataka Chief Minister H.D. Kumaraswamy has said that Mamata Banerjee is fit to lead the country. But other Gathbandhan partners have been speaking in different voices.
उत्तर प्रदेश ने हमेशा प्रधानमंत्री दिया है और हमें खुशी होगी कि उत्तर प्रदेश से फिर एक प्रधानमंत्री बने.
As a son of the Thalaivar Kalaignar, I propose the candidature of Rahul Gandhi from Tamil Nadu.
The Congress on its part is keeping its cards close to its chest, refraining from projecting its party president as the PM face.
Modi सरकार का हर अंग घबरा गया है. उस घबराहट और बौखलाहट का ही ये परिणाम है कि इस प्रकार के बेतुके, झूठ, बेमानी, असत्य वक्तव्य आ रहे हैं.
It's clear that the battle for 2019 will be Modi versus the rest. What isn't clear, however, is who will be crowned the winner if the Gathbandhan does manage to trounce the BJP. Bureau Report, India Today.
Is a Mahagathbandhan against Prime Minister Modi even viable? And are regional satraps getting together to edge the Congress party and Rahul Gandhi to the pillion? Arun Jetley attacking the Congress, saying at best they can hope to ride pillion with the opposition leaders. To talk about the rapidly emerging political situation in India, we're joined at this time by Sambit Patra from the BJP, Sanjay Jha of the Congress, Manisha Priyam, leading political analyst, and also Ghanshyam Tiwari of the Samajwadi Party. The big rally in Kolkata, Sanjay Jha, symbolizes in many ways the isolation of Rahul Gandhi. His absence was ringing loudly. He wasn't on the dais. And even when the other leaders were speaking, they were talking about the possibility of a Mamata Banerjee or maybe even a Mayawati becoming Prime Minister. Arun Jaitley says in 2019, at best, Rahul Gandhi can hope to ride pillion. He has no more role than that.
Oh, well, Rahul, you're going to have a non-BJP Prime Minister who will take oath in May of 2019. The very fact that, you know, end of day, Arun Jaitley is reduced to writing blogs to somehow create some degree of an animated discussion on the alliance that is actually a work in progress. And, you know, the manifestation of the fact that everybody's united was evident in Kolkata. The fact is that the BJP today is rattled. They are seeing the writing on the wall, at least I hope for their own survival they are. You know, what happened in Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh and Rajasthan is symptomatic of the larger national change that is clearly going to happen. And, you know, as far as Mr. Rahul Gandhi not being there, this is a very synthetic, a very pathetic cosmetic attack. Mr. Kharge was there. He's the leader of the Congress party in the Lok Sabha. Mr. Abhishek Singhvi was there. And I don't think these are even matters of any critical significance. I mean, why doesn't the BJP answer that Yashwant Sinha and Shatrughan Sinha and Arun Shori, three very eminent leaders of the BJP, were sharing the platform with the opposition? So, end of day, India is seeing a very, very distinctive shift. It is unstoppable. The question is, how low will the BJP fall? And Narendra Modi's incompetence in handling the issues of unemployment, rural distress, national security, destroying the institutions of our country, and putting India's democracy and constitution at risk is going to ultimately decimate the BJP.
Sambit Patra, you know, Sanjay Jha is calling this a pathetic attack by the blogging minister Arun Jaitley. I come back to you, Sanjay Jha, in just a moment. He's also questioning the presence of BJP MP Shatrughan Sinha at the dais with opposition leaders. And the fact also is a lot of what we are hearing the regional parties say at this time is muscle flexing. To his constituents, they want to reach out and make it seem as if they're going to be in with a chance of becoming Prime Minister in the hope of increasing their tally. And all of what will actually happen will be known only after the results come out towards the end of May. Therefore, if the opposition doesn't have a clear Prime Ministerial candidate, the BJP also has its own sets of problems with the likes of Arun Shori, Yashwant Sinha, Shatrughan Sinha, all of them sharing the stage with the opposition leaders, and you haven't thrown someone like a Shatrughan Sinha out of your party even now, Sambit Patra.
Rahul, first and foremost, when my good friend Mr. Sanjay Jha from the Congress party says that everyone is united on the dais in Kolkata and we are afraid of it, my question is, where are they united? Just holding hands does not make a Mahagathbandhan. While the Congress party was holding hands with the Samajwadi party and the BSP, please tell me, Mahagathbandhan means sheet sharing, it means a common leadership, it means common ideology. Are they contesting together in Uttar Pradesh? Of course not. In fact, in Uttar Pradesh, the Congress party has been relegated to the third position amongst the so-called contestants of the Mahagathbandhan. It is not being cared for. Secondly, and extremely importantly, I was shocked when my friend Mr. Sanjay Jha used these two words, that we, the BJP, is fighting the battle for survival, and he said that the BJP is rattled. My question is, who is fighting the war for survival? Of course, it is the Congress party and all these so-called allies who are not allied as yet. They are the ones who are fighting a last pitch fight for their own survival. As far as who is rattled is concerned, if you are not rattled, if the condition of the country is so bad under the leadership of Mr. Modi, then why don't you contest alone? Why don't you defeat the Bharatiya Janata Party alone? If the condition of the country is so bad under Mr. Narendra Modi that you need to come together, come together in the sense that you're seemingly coming together, okay, only shows that
Sanjay
you are
Jha, this is an Let attack we're seeing constantly second, from second, the top Rahul. BJP leadership. The Prime Minister also said that they're so rattled that the only thing that the opposition has is Modi Hatao. because I'm the chowkidar, because I'm preventing corruption, therefore they don't want me in the picture, they want to edge me out. Their sole agenda is Modi Hatao. It was similar when in 1971 everyone went to the public saying Indira Hatao, she said Garibi Hatao, and we saw what happened then. Is there a fear that the opposition, by making this Modi-centric, could help the Prime Minister and the BJP build up sympathy, saying they want to move the chowkidar because he's doing an honest job and all the chores and luteras want to come in? Sanjay Jha, respond to the BJP's attack.
Well, let me tell you, for Mr. Narendra Modi, unfortunately, none of this grandstanding is going to work anymore. All across the streets of India, the popular slogan of our times is Chowkidar Chor Hai. Now, let me answer your question on Mr. Modi's attack on the Congress party or the other opposition parties. You know, Rahul, the BJP is now like that Titanic. It's a sinking ship. Look at their own arrangements. They have over 40 people, regional parties, who supported them in their Lok Sabha victory. 17 of them have deserted them already. You have the JDU, which is actually now saying that they're going to oppose the citizenship amendment bill in Assam. Uddhav Thackeray, one of their principal alliance partners in Maharashtra, is said, we endorse Mr. Rahul Gandhi's accusation against the Prime Minister on the Rafael scam of 1,30,000 crores. Uddhav Thackeray says that Mr. Gandhi is justified in saying ki gali gali mein shor hai, chowkidar chor hai. This is the state of the BJP. It's frangible. Rahul, it's a collapsing house of cards. I mean, end of day, Mr. Modi can try all his muscular 56 inch ki bravado, but end of day, your house is now virtually in shambles. And this is basically a reflection of public disillusionment. The youth, the farmers, I think practically everybody from the Dalit community. You have Savitri Bai Phule, who resigned from the BJP and said the BJP is using Dalits as a photo op and they're actually misleading the Dalit community. Let's not even talk of the minorities who are being lynched to death in broad daylight. So Narendra Modi's biggest legacy to India is the destruction of our society and demonetization.
Okay, Sambit Patra wants to make a quick counter before I go across to the Samajwadi Party. You know, I know there are two big parties involved, but the regional allies will have a role to play as well. So Ghanshyam will come in, but before that, we'll take a counter from Sambit Patra. Sambit.
With all those homilies by Sanjay Jha, I mean, do we consider that the people of this country are fools? They don't understand what the reality is? Rahul, with all due respect, I would say, who is chowkidar, who is chor? Who is honest and who is dishonest? Who is corrupt, who is a good man fighting against corruption? Just close your eyes, keep your hand on your heart. Each one of us, those on the panel and those watching this great channel, they would all know the answers. As far as the larger point is concerned, only today, since morning till evening, India Today has been showing as to what is happening. In fact, in Karnataka, as to how one of the MLAs of Congress party itself using a wine bottle has hit the head of another Congress MLA. This is a classic case of anarchy for power, a classic case of chaos for power, and that chaos is what we are visualizing in this so-called Mahagathbandhan. I have only one word to say. As far as 2019 is concerned, it is a fight between the leaders and the dealers. There is only one leader as far as BJP and the country and the aspiration of the country is concerned, that is Modi. As far as dealers are concerned, someone is fighting against the NHRM case, someone is fighting against the National Herald case, someone is acquitted, I mean, someone is prosecuted for the Chara Ghotala, someone in fact is facing the ED for all kind of land acquisitions. So it's but natural that all these people for whom PM means pehle mai, so PM Ghanshyam for them does
Tiwari,
not mean performance,
you know,
and
the BJP it will means say, pehle mai. Janata Dal Secular Congress Alliance in Karnataka is an example of what people can expect. You've got a small regional force tying up with a major national party, running a government. We're seeing instability. We're seeing multiple complaints about corruption. And we are here seeing the sense ki abhi giri, kab giri, kab giri, ab giri. You know, that's not the kind of India that voters would want. Do you fear, you know, and that's the point the BJP is making, that the message that could be going out is on the one side there is stability, on the other side there is chaos. And Karnataka is a prime example of what to expect if regional parties get together with the Congress to try and run a government.
Well, I'm shocked to see senior leaders like Arun Jaitley, who's a cabinet minister, or Prakash Javadekar, getting reduced to just mere political analysts who cannot say or speak today of what they have done. Rather, they only scaremonger the voter that about the change that lies ahead. It is like in a cricket match, the team that is batting and is losing keeps commenting, instead of their batsman coming and batting, keeps telling the umpire, do you know if we lose, what would happen to the cricket? Well, this nation is going to vote for change. BJP can take it as a mandate for change or can add their adjectives. The reality is they have not solved the agenda of jobs. They have made it life difficult for farmers, and they have destructed the social harmony in the country. Now, the response is not that, look at Karnataka example. The shortest and most unstable government in the history of Karnataka was the BJP government. That had to run away while the national anthem was playing. And the so-called Majboot Sarkar has destabilized government from Jammu Kashmir to Tamil Nadu across, and from Goa all the way to Arunachal Pradesh. So this Majboot Sarkar has meant destruction of Indian democratic system. And that is why the spirit of change is emerging from state to state. And in each state, there is a credible leader and a credible alliance that is building up the public momentum for change.
Rahul. You know, we're currently in Davos, right outside the Congress, where the World Economic Forum will be held, Sambit. And when I came last year and speaking to various officials, functionaries at WEF, speaking to businessmen over here, everybody was talking about the kind of mandate and majority that the Prime Minister would get and how big a majority would the BJP be back with. I won't name them, but multiple industrialists and senior functionaries of the World Economic Forum since this morning have been asking just one question. Is Modi going to lose? You know, suddenly from what was, Sambit Patra, a sure shot election, a sure shot re-election for the Prime Minister, now the world doesn't know. Earlier there was certainty and people were talking about Modi till 2024. Now everyone here in Davos is asking, jeet bhi rahe ki haar bhi rahe, what do you think is happening? And industrialists who were big staunch supporters suddenly seem rather uncertain, Sambit.
See, as far as this question is concerned, I would say that such is the nature of Indian politics and such is the nature of Indian electorate and elections, that of course there are challenges before every election, but I can sure shot say that Mr. Modi is going to be the Prime Minister. These were the talks, remember, before the UP elections also. Are you going to win? There was demonetization. The Congress party was alleging that we had destroyed the whole structure in Uttar Pradesh, but we had seen the result, 325 seats we got in Uttar Pradesh. So I believe that we have to be patient. I'm sure that truth is going to be triumphant. But having said that, the larger question is just an example. Look at the hypocrisy of these people who are coming together. We had Mr. Arvind Kejriwal only about 4.5 years ago. He coined the term, ye sare chor hai, the famous term, ye sab chor hai, and in which he had a list of people who were the chors, quote unquote chors. He said that Sarad Pawar sabse bade chor hai. Then he said, ye sare Congress ke jitne minister hai, sab chor hai. And ironically, he was sitting beside Sarad Pawar yesterday. Do you feel the people of this country are fooled? Do you feel people of this country are not going to see through? And ironically, yesterday, while Mr. Sarad Yadav was delivering a lecture out there in Bengal, he was saying that Bofors ka ghotala kitna bada ghotala tha. Very well, they know within themselves what the originality is, what the truth is. It is only the survival for their own existence that they have taken this battle for. But remember, someone has come up with a beautiful article today in a Hindi daily saying that 50
Manisha Priyam, we've seen...
bana dete hain.
Yes.
तो वो दिवाली नहीं होती है
ओके मनीषा प्रियम वी हैव सीन मल्टीपल इंस्टेंसेस ऑफ बैड न्यूज फॉर द महागठबंधन ओवर द पास्ट फ्यू डेज द एसपी एंड द बीएसपी नॉट अकोमोडेटिंग द कांग्रेस इन द अलायंस ममता बैनर्जी स्ट्राइकिंग ऑन हर ओन we're seeing, for example, in Andhra Pradesh, TDP uncertain about whether they want to be with the Congress or not. Do you believe that this is A, inevitable, or do you believe that the expectation that people had after the three assembly state elections, that the opposition would come together as one, is now being deflated, that this is making it tougher to dislodge Modi, tougher for the opposition to be able to beat the BJP in the 2019 general elections? Manisha Priyam.
So these are just the opening innings as far as the 2019 elections are concerned. Remember the three state elections that were held recently and that the BJP did not do very well in. Now in those elections, the pitch definitely got to be slightly anti-BJP. So that disadvantage, but the advantage of having swept through UP. So it is a kind of a pincer moment when the BJP has done it in an extraordinary sort of way in Uttar Pradesh, and yet the BJP has also lost the important Hindi heartland states. So it's a kind of a pincer moment. The best show that the opposition has been able to put together has been at the Brigade Mahadiveshan in Kolkata, but it does seem early innings as far as the Mahagathbandhan or the Brigade Mahadiveshan, as we may call it. They still have to formulate what could be a common minimum agenda. And yes, the big leaders of the Congress party were not there, but Mallikarjun Kharge was there. He's an important leader from the state of Karnataka and an important Dalit leader from that state. So yes, a very strong presence. What was also noticeable about the Brigade Mahadiveshan was that small, younger, newer players like Hardik Patel and Jignesh Mevani sat on the same stage and spoke out as Mr. Sharad Pawar or Mr. Yashwant Sinha. So I would say this is the first momentum. But unless we see what the common minimum program is, we do not know for sure.
But as far as the BJP why was Rahul Gandhi not present in Kolkata?
One second.
You know why? Why?
Rahul.
Why was Rahul Gandhi not present in Kolkata? Is that a mistake? If he'd been part of the opposition leaders, it would have seemed as if it's one team. It's almost as if he's, you know, wanting to stay away and yet wanting to be friends with them.
Well, let me tell you one thing, Rahul. The Congress party is absolutely politically flexible. We respect all regional aspirations, and we are convinced that everyone is on the same page to make sure that there is a government, there is a political party led by Amit Shah and Narendra Modi, who are completely determined to destroy Indian democracy. And I think this has been built over several decades, and we can't allow that to happen. I want to answer one question. I was in Uttar Pradesh yesterday, Rahul, and you can't imagine the anger of the common man of India on Narendra Modi for demonetization, for the black money that never came, for the number of people who have actually benefited on account of demonetization because they knew that it was going to be announced, who converted their black money to white. And then you have a situation, by the way, where at the end of the day, the farming community, the rural economy has been virtually destroyed. So these are the realities. And in fact, somebody mentioned ki jo jhoot bolna to inka ek ada hai. झूठ बोलना तो इनका एक अदा है जो इन पर विश्वास कर ले वो सबसे बड़ा गधा है सो दीज वर द काइंड ऑफ यू नो काइंड ऑफ अल्फाज दैट वर बीइंग शेयर्ड पीपल रियलाइज दैट यू नो एंड ऑफ डे नरेंद्र मोदी हैज डन नथिंग बट ही हैज टेकन द पीपल फॉर अ राइड एंड ऑफ डे नरेंद्र मोदी एंड अमित शाह have believed through their political arrogance that they can say what they want to, they can change the names of schemes, they can make all kinds of rhetorical announcements, nothing for the common man. Narendra Modi will be remembered for is demonetization and the Rafael scam.
Rebuttal, because I have a commitment elsewhere, please allow me a rebuttal and with your permission I would
okay, Sambit wants to counter.
Thanks.
Yes.
Thank you.
Sambit.
Thank you. Thank you for your grace, because I just have a commitment elsewhere. I'll be very quick. Rahul, what my friend Mr. Sanjay Jha right now said, that Congress is ready for political flexibility. I would say that what Mr. Sanjay Jha is trying to do is, he is masquerading political compulsion as political flexibility, as if the Samajwadi Party and BSP were ready to give n number of seats in Uttar Pradesh to the Congress Party, and they said, "Nahi, hum bada dil dikha ke hum nahi ladenge." It is not that. The Congress Party has become a political untouchable today, which most of the other political parties, well, they may be accommodating on a dais and the hand-holding exercise may be visible, but when the seat distribution comes, no one is ready to accommodate the Congress Party. Secondly, and extremely important, I just want to say one thing. Please, for God's sake, Sanjay Jha, don't, in fact, demean the people of India by calling them gadha. I mean, you are a learned man, an intelligent man, I respect you for that, but such kind of derogatory words for the Indian electorate is something which I firmly believe
aapne
you should not be using.
Bahut
thank you
banaya. Aapne logo ko
with your
bahut
permission Rahul
banaya.
I would take your leave. Thank you.
Okay, Ghanshyam Tiwari, you need to respond to this. You know, what's the agenda for the Mahagathbandhan? The best agenda cannot be Modi hatao. There has to be a vision. You know, in concrete terms, what's the kind of governance that this motley alliance of so many different parties will deliver if you were given an opportunity to come to power? Your single point agenda cannot be remove Modi, remove Modi, remove Modi. How does that work? What's the other agenda? Ghanshyam Tiwari.
It's a, It's a fair and good question. When we speak to people, the agenda of the country has not shifted from 2014. The Achhe Din is still an agenda. It is just that the BJP is scared to repeat that slogan of Achhe Din. And the agenda is still that the youth require jobs, that the farmer requires some sort of sustainability, a better prosperity in their agriculture, and the country requires amity in a social situation, a social harmony, atmosphere of social harmony. It is the BJP that cheated the people on that agenda. As a result, it is not an agenda of Mahagathbandhan versus the agenda of BJP. The agenda of people is very straightforward. BJP is scared of addressing it.
Okay, Manisha Priyam, final words. In this political chessboard, in the next few days, what do you believe will be the next moves? If, Kolkata was a kind of tracer of what to expect, you know, this is lots of parties coming together, not entirely cohesive, but nonetheless united in the resolve to oust Modi. What do you think will be the chess moves that will be made by the various players over just the next few days and weeks? Manisha Priyam.
Okay, so for the BJP itself, that in the next few days or the week to come, the attack on each of these regional parties will increase, plus the cases, etc., the noose will tighten on each of these regional parties. So that will be from the BJP, a clear offensive going out really on the offensive. That's what is to be expected. As far as the Mahagathbandhan or the Mahadivation of the brigade is concerned, one should expect that in the next few, in the next week or so, one would look forward to seeing what their common minimum agenda is. So that's something that's clearly expected. How are they going to develop a working group? What is the kind of seat sharing and campaigning arrangement that can be seen there? And what are the important leaders in which constituencies, where will they be fielded? So what will be the cross-regional workings? What is the common minimum team that will come up? Unless that can be seen, this will be seen as a political stage, all right, for a critique, but not yet ready to go in poll mode, not yet ready in the battle mode. So clearly they will have to go and play their first innings there. But I think the important noise also is being made by the JDU, remember, which has today gone into the Assam issue, saying they want to dissociate themselves on this particular issue from the BJP. One doesn't quite understand that the JDU, which has an important regional existence in Bihar and is the BJP's strongest ally, has close to the hustings decided to say that we want to have a separate voice on this issue. So clearly the game is open, advantage BJP at this point of time, but what the next moves will be from that size, the cobbling together of regional parties, that's clearly got to be seen in the next week or 10 days, unless the clear moves are made. The critique coming from Modi saying they don't have any common agenda except to defeat me, that's the noise that may go down well to the electorate.
Okay, so I'm going to wrap up this part of the broadcast. I want to thank all our guests. I want to show you where we are. We're at the World Economic Forum Congress. This is where, in just a short while from now, World Economic Forum 2019, focusing this time on the fourth industrial revolution. This is about digitization, this is about blockchain, artificial economy, and it gets started in just a few hours. Tomorrow is when the business leg starts. There will be the Crystal Awards this evening. We're tracking all that's happening, especially with an eye on India. Is Global Inc. in a invest in India mode, or are they in a wait and watch mode?
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also, check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.